level 6 ulti from Alistar is going to do a lot of work. There it is!
Yeah. So we're playing the side lanes.
Not too much a surprise with the Jace. I'm really excited. I like this TL comp. It's more proactive than what
being the extra man, bringing up your mid laner. So at worst, it's going to be that one extra guy, and they force out the TP with it.
There's a knockback. Alfar's going to buy some space, but where is he going to get the reinforcements from? They're not going to be there. 100 Thieves find first blood in the top lane.
They do buy themselves time to get Scuttlecrab and actually get the reset for Jensen, who still has his ultimate.
Headbutt, flash, pull, fries, but Tactical gets it blocked by a support. Hoopy pulls right back in. Hoopy's got the ulti on. Braum goes in for the knockup. Leeson coming around as well, but no kick available. Makes his fight a bit difficult, so Jhin opens up. They're going to find the stun. They're going to find the execution. And they won't quite get Core JJ, but it's 2-0 on the board for 100 Thieves. Looking for the third. Can you slice through? He's going to flash, going to find the stun. TF here for the help. Somebody healed by some time. Someday has been stunned, and the Jhin W will not land. They got to walk right back out of this one.
And they have to be quick about it because this entire time, Alfar.
Hex flash! And he's in for the headbutt pull for us. Corjay gonna flash to safety now as well. Health bar still very, very low, but again, safety has been found. And this whole time, Alfari is getting stuff done in top lane. Last game, it was 4 kills for 4 plates. This time, it's 1 kill for 4 plates.
Not yet.
A second kill for 4 plates. Still, though, that is a lot of money to earn at the end of the day.
It is. I mean, he's gonna get utilizing their double TP from the solo laners, but not really coming out with, I think, enough to justify it. And this gets actually so difficult now because you spent double TP, you didn't really get a huge reward, you didn't get the dragon. No vision on this top side for Alfari. He has this line of wards, that's it. So that is why he is playing so far back. It is very dark up there.
Headbutt pulls a lot of damage, going for the execute, and they're gonna get it. Santorin is down 4-0 in kills.
Guess what? Who he does find his play right out of the brush there. Alistar combo over the top sets up closer. All you need is one point man to get somebody chunk for closer. He immediately executes them. The Viego now getting a kill is going to start to cause some trepidation on the side of Team Liquid because they had already gotten the Rift Herald, so the rewards of getting a pick are that much bigger.
Flash for the gold card, a great flash over the wall, but Efra's still in. Follow up, no, the shockwave on a 3! The pulverize to follow! Is it gonna be enough? They find a stun, Jhin opens up! Will Jhin close it down? Corjay puts on the shield, the fourth shot would get a kill, but it's gonna miss. That said, Closer is still in. Headbutt pulls back in for the Alistar. Kill number 5 has been found. Number 6, they wanna get it, but first one is traded back by Alfari, who himself will fall into the turret. A triple kill for Closer.
So far, very few teams been able to do so. Team Liquid is in that list.
I think there's no shot we see it in another game in the series. I think they're not going to give it over to him again.
But honestly, TL do at least own the river. The flank, I agree with, but the river itself is dotted most with TL control wards.
There
but
it is.
They're getting pushed out. Here's the Renekton TP, who he's at half health, but he's out, so he can survive that one. Aftershock plus the ulti is going to be pretty good. However, someday TP's into enemy champions. It's enough to fight Alfari, sets it up, and someday knocks it down. 1-0. Your top focus means nothing when the other team just plays the fights better. All of the gold has been killed, and 100 Thieves win the fight.
It all comes down to the vision control here. 100 Thieves with so many deep wards, even with the quick response there from Jensen trying to turn it into a 2v1 against someday. He's too tanky at this point with the Gore Trigger.
So long here, and now in the final showing up. Emily mentioned, well, we're going to have a pick here first.
Goodbye.
Doesn't need any commentating. He's dead freak. Meanwhile, you know, Emily was mentioning the Shen pocket pick for him, and yet Renekton is his most played champion, most well known for, shows up here big. Guess what, Freak? Another pick!
And Santorin will be jumped upon, and we got another Lee Sin in the house right now, as Huhi and Close are going to have to walk their way back out. Flash back in the queue. Huhi could die. No, of course he can't, but they still have two towers, and Closer, he's got to be careful. Running away with Rend in his back, and the shutdown comes through. Finally, another kill on the board. Team Liquid double that count. FBI now being chased apart. This could be enough. A flash backwards. Huhi is likely to drop. You gotta be kidding me. The man won't die, but he has only 4 HP. He's gotta keep running. FBI gonna cleanse. This has gotta be enough. This has to work. There's the gold card. There's the damage. There's another kill in for Alfari, and Huhi's got nowhere to go. Team Liquid breathe some life into their game.
Who are gonna go for the 1v1 of the tower? Execute at the end.
Shockwave is available. Dodges the shock blast. Can he do it better? Pulls in the top laner. Nice. Here comes the jungler. Kicks back in. Stopwatch buys the time, and Tactical has 5 HP, so they gotta watch out for this one. Lee Sin finds a kill into Orianna. Smite for help. The Centaur's gotta walk away. Someday very low as well. Closer can't quite get his kill for the reset. Ulti is up.
So 1k plus for Alfari there, yep. And all of a sudden he's more relevant in the side lane, but the TP flank.
Here we go. Play to the mid lane. Tactical and Core TJ, the targets flash up on both, though. The first one comes across. They're going to pull in the second, but will he still die? Thurston's on top of him. Closer on the chase, but they can't get the kill. Core TJ will be the target. Core TJ likely to drop, dodging all the shots. And you got to be kidding. The man's going to live. Closer can't finish that one off. Hoohee, dangerously low as well. Something takes a shock blast.
I mean, it's great. TP was used there by 100 Thieves. They were looking for the kills into the dragon or the kills into the now until they are back together, because you have to watch
look
out for
deficit now. 700 for Team Liquid. 100 Thieves walking in. Tactical, great stopwatch buys time, but a team fight is now what we're going to see. Pulverize on a two, most likely, but they're still cutting away pretty well. The shield's in front, double shockwave, might mean a kill. Corje pushes them right back out, and Alfari wants in, can't find the kill. Goldcar going to find FBI, dueling in a 1v1, his exhaust is on, who he forced to run away, and now in comes Corje. Jay wants to set up on the mid laner. Will they find the kill in Abadaga? Yes, they will. 2-0 for the Jace, but Closer may have come alive. He's ignited, has very little health, but he gets two kills. He gets the reset, and now it's time to find a kill on a Jensen. As this could be it for the kill. Yes, finds the stun.
Oh.
And again, Closer just makes it happen.
The Ruined King indeed. It's King Closer, and he's coming for the base next. Push right in. The minion wave already here, so the rewards are basically doubled for 100 Thieves. Tower down. Inhibitor going to be soon to follow.
Inhibitor turret going to fall for sure. Inhibitor itself often secures a Baron. I think the base itself might be too tough to actually knock down. They are going to back up for this one, and we'll see if they can rush down that
low enough to provide souls for Closer.
And another team fight, another half health target. Core JJ pops in the lock, has the shield up, and a stopwatch buys some time. Knocked back in, but there's the first kill. Braum is still prey. Jin finds the second one. Centaurian gets big shields, but it's not going to matter there either. Closer is in for another. A killing spree
this
now on the Diego.
End. They're going to go mid. They have the super minions. It's just two members here from TL trying to hold on against five.
So far, the top focus has not paid off for Team Liquid, but at least they survived more than 30 minutes. That said, 100 Thieves have still been the dominant team here in the finals. 1-0 was quick. 2-0 not long after. Nexus turret's under fire, and Alfari and Jensen, these solo laners, will not even step up. They'll preserve the KDA instead of fighting for their lives. It wouldn't matter anyway. The Nexus falls, and 100 Thieves are one game away from hoisting.